Back on Worldwide Wrestling, time for main event wrestling at its best. Tag team action, you know, Brain. Two great tag teams coming out here.
Right, John Dillinger and Babyface Nelson, better known as Johnny Grunge and Flyboy Rocco, Public Enemy, number one and two.
Here they are, Public Enemy. Well, they really are a gruesome twosome, aren't they?
I wonder who the nucleus of his group is he hangs with. Doctors, lawyers, investment counselors. Or you think guys are on parole?
I think the latter. South Philadelphia, Harlem Heat will be coming out here in just a moment to face these two men.
Do you hear what they're going to do now in South Philly? They're going to tear it all down and build a slum.
It's not nice.
It isn't. It's not very bad.
Philadelphia's a great town.
Because it has an airport. You can get out.
Here they come, big and tough as they come in our sport. Stevie Ray, Booker T, Harlem Heat.
And I still can't believe how Booker T and Sting secured a win over the Road Warriors in the first time ever they had ever lost a Chicago street fight.
I can tell you how. The big guy right there, Stevie Ray. Thanks to Lex Luger. Thanks to Jimmy Hart. Now, that's not taking away from Booker T and Sting. They had a great match. They worked fine as a team. But obviously, they won the match in ways that Sting would not approve of. Sting would not be happy with once he views the videotape.
Well, then let him send back part of the check he doesn't think he should be happy with.
He might do that.
Well, then do it. Send it to me, and I'll make sure it gets to the right people.
I'm sure you will.
Matter of fact, don't send the check. You can't trust the mail anymore. Just leave some cash. I'll let you know later where. Small denominations would be fine.
You know, you're a criminal.
I'm not a criminal.
You're a criminal.
Not a criminal.
Small denominations, I'll tell you where to leave it.
Well, yeah, I have different places where I meet people. And if you don't have cash, I'll take bond stocks, credit cards,
but
jewelry, cameras, and China. I don't know if anybody in society today really likes the look of street people. Tough part of the way the world is right now, but, you know, they call them homeless. We used to just call them bums.
Here we go. Time for tag team action, and the teams are taking their good old time. A little stalemate going on here. Jimmy Jett calls for the bell. It's time for Harlem Heat and Public Enemy on Worldwide Wrestling. Now, remember, when the Lethal Lottery comes around in May, and we'll be talking more about it, Harlem Heat, good chance they'll be split on different teams. Same thing with Public Enemy.
But what would happen if Harlem Heat drew Harlem Heat? I mean, what an advantage that would be.
That would be the biggest advantage.
Boy. Or a Hogan drew a Savage or a Booty Man.
We'll be talking more about Starrcade, celebrating the past, present, and future of our great sport. In the weeks to come, it comes your way on the 19th of May. And only on pay-per-view. Back to the corner now. There's a back elbow by Flyboy Rocco Rock. There's a back elbow bow by Flyboy Rocco Rock. Hello, is your headset on?
Yeah, he looks a lot like Eddie Murphy, don't he? Booker T.
I don't know. Yeah, maybe so. A fighting Eddie Murphy.
A tough Eddie Murphy.
Yeah, you're not kidding. Side of the head. To the chin, to the jaw, to the forehead that time. It's where you don't want to be against guys like Public Enemy. They love to put you in a corner and brawl.
But as big as Harlem Heat and as tough as they are, I would get them on the mat and keep them down. They can wrestle, but I'd keep them down. You don't want to match strength with these two guys. And sure, Public Enemy, they're tough guys on the street when they got a board and garbage can lid and a fire hydrant or something like that. But you don't want to stand toe-to-toe with Harlem Heat. They've been there. They've been tag team champions. And they're two big, tough customers.
Johnny Grunge trying to slow down these two big, tough customers. Harlem Heat. I tell you what, they're throwing a tantrum on the outside.
Well, that's good. I like that. When I managed a tag team, I always wanted the guy to be off the wall. I wanted to be able to control him, too. But I wouldn't mind if he banged his head off the floor. If that's what got him moving, do it. Fine. Whatever you need to motivate yourself. If you feel you have to Bang your own head into the floor, do it, or slam the car door in your head, that's fine.
Yeah, just don't bother me until the paycheck comes in, right, Brain? That's what type of manager you are.
No. Do you ever have a car door slammed on your head?
No.
Well, wait till we're done.
I don't think I want that.
It's not really a car door. It's a minivan. I can slide it into the side of your head. You'll enjoy it just as much.
Top of the head. In the forehead again. Johnny Grunch into the near side. Look at this power. Stevie Ray hoist him up and dropped him down.
Picked him up where he got him and deposited him where he got him.
Back elbow from Stevie Ray. Goes down to get him, not letting Rocco rock or make it fly boy. Johnny Grunge up. Elbow. Grunge up on top. Here he goes. Across the air and down to the mat.
These men are very dangerous when it comes to furniture, you know.
Oh, yes.
Public enemy, yeah.
They love to use that table, don't they?
They're barred at most Denny's across the country. Yeah, they go right off the grill, over the buffet table, right through the smorgy. Oh, it's a mess. With a waitress on their back.
Oh, good. Very graphic. Glad to know about that one.
They just don't care.
That's obvious. Look at them.
Well, they have a style about them.
Yeah, they sure do. There's a spin wheel kick. One, two. It's a save by Flyboy. That saved the match there, Brain.
And he didn't get caught. The referee made him get back out. He didn't disqualify him, so he got away with it.
It's called a break. Used to be able to get two breaks during the match. That was long ago. Now there's more. You can break or cause a break as many times as you want. Double team.
I think they should lax the rules more.
How much more could you lax the rules in pro wrestling?
Well,
I mean, they pretty much handicap these referees in a tag team match. There should be two referees. In a six-man, three referee.
Well, but I believe if you feel that you want to take it out on a Nick Patrick or a Randy Anderson and you want to beat him up for a while, you should be able to do that. I think a manager ought to be able to run on the field and body slam an umpire if he feels like it.
Why don't you write to Major League Baseball with that one?
Well, my good friend, the American League president, Gene Buttig, I'm going to discuss a few things with him about this.
He's your good friend?
Very good friend of mine. He talks very highly of you.
Really?
No.
Up on the top rope. Whoa, to make you quiver. Seizing the opportunity in a great move by Booker T.
Yeah, let them go. Let them do what they want. Everything should be uncensored, as far as I'm concerned. Just keep me away from it.
Here we go again. Back body drop. That time it was two men. One, two, no.
What if the Nasties were teamed with one of Public Enemy?
Couldn't tell the difference, actually.
Well, sure you could tell the difference. Public Enemy's a lot more handsome.
You think that?
I'm pretty sure of it.
I think it just kind of blends together. Back into the corner, the double team Harlem Heat.
Four good-looking guys.
Harlem Heat. By winning the... When Booker T and Sting won the Chicago Street Fight, Booker T, Stevie Ray had their World Tag Team title shot coming up against Lex Luger and Sting very soon. That was the stipulation laid forth and agreed to by both men.
Boy, Jimmy Hart, can you see him in those negotiations, what he's going to ask for? The money he's going to ask for, the percentage, and is Sting going to go along with that? Because I can see that meeting. I can see Sting and Luger in there. Jimmy Hart comes in with his big briefcase. Sting's going to say, I don't want to talk with this man in the room. They're going to have a hard time putting this one together.
Yeah, he's really tough to deal with. I understand Jimmy is a tough negotiator, much in the same league of a Bobby the Brain Heenan when he was a manager.
Well, I mean, I learned that all from my good friend George Steinbrenner. You have to be tough when you're in business.
Meanwhile, being tough is what Stevie Ray's all about. He's taking on both men. Booker T is in the corner, hurting a little bit. Stevie Ray hung up on the top now. And that's going to enable a double team by Public Enemy. Harlem Heat in major trouble now.
This is where they're at their best.
Moonsault on his own man. Oof. To the midsection. Out goes Flyboy. I'm not sure who the legal man is. I believe it's Flyboy Rocco Rock.
I don't think it matters anymore.
I don't think it ever did, actually. German suplex, rolls him up. He's got him. Uh-oh. Over the top he goes.
That's it. See, you don't... I don't like this rule.
Disqualification is in the book. It's going to be a win for Booker T and Stevie Ray when one member of Harlem Heat was dumped over the top. Ducks clothesline. Stevie Ray got one. The other one pulled down. A fight still ensues here.
What I guarantee you the Road Warriors are watching this.
Yes.
So is Luger and Sting.
And the Steiners.
Oh, yeah, the Steiners. How can you forget them?
And the Blue Bloods. Wow. Harlem Heat, though, score a win. It'll go down the record books as a win, but the fight's not over between these two teams. And the fight's not over in World Championship Wrestling and the tag team scene as well.
Yeah, I want them back in there right now.
This portion of WCW Worldwide Wrestling is brought to you by Pep Boys. 26,000 items at the guaranteed low price. Tires and service, everything but gas.